R.I.P. R.I.P. that. What am I watching right now? Oh, this is my window.
Here I am thinking I have one of the easiest fucking names to spell, and then Starbucks pulls this shit. Like, I'm fucking sorry, you is Stefan Yang?
You just had an abortion.
Stefan Yang.
Twins. Twins.
Mm. Yeah, double homicide.
What?
Bitch.
I'm on the world.
Hey,
dude.
Do your thing.
She's hurting him so bad. Oh, it's a dog. Oh, is she gonna dance? This is fake. Come on, man.
Yeah, toxic. I'm slipping on.
Mr. Rock. Oh. And Mickey.
That's my girl. That's my girl.
Hold on, can y'all be quiet for
one
second?
I'm eating. Hey, Kehlani. I'm eating. Frozen spray while this photo was taken.
Hello?
Hello. I'm looking at TikToks from McDonald's. Ayo. Roll on. That wasn't me. Hi guys. Runs bro live. Hang on, I'm tweeting right now. Oh. Speaking of Twitter, I just realized that they changed the font. Oh my gosh.
I'm really sick and tired of everyone saying that.
They changed the font on Twitter.
I don't have an Android, but I know people that do.
Hello, what you do? Hello. Hello. Hello, love. How you doing?
The same fucking camera quality. It's the same quality, and everyone gets so fucking dumb and shitty about it.
That was like my stream right there.
In Canabula. May I please have the definition?
So that wasn't my computer breaking. It's just Twitter. Yeah, it's Twitter. Twitter changed its font for everybody. Everybody changed that font. Yeah, it's very true. Yeah.
In Canabula.
In Canabula.
How do you spell that? But she is out in round 5.
Oh my gosh. Okay, anyways, I'm doing music stuff, guys. Hang on. Is that Michael Jackson? Wait, is that actually Michael Jackson? I thought that was fake for... That's Michael Jackson? I don't believe that's Michael Jackson. Hang on, I'm eating frozen Sprite. Mmm. That was cool.
I don't know. I just don't think this is like right for me. I don't want to do it. I want to go home. Like, I can't take the pressure of it. But don't you think any job interview?
Bye.
Around Saint Zero Ned, then this happened.
Oh, I thought that was a man. Hi, Kita. Hey, girl. Hang on. I'm going to switch to my mouse that I'm more comfortable with using. Hey, guys. Today I'm working on some music. I also changed the way my OBS is laid out. It's just way different because, like, I don't have a vertical monitor anymore. Here, let me show you. Let me show you how my OBS is laid out now, okay? You mind if I show you a screenshot that I just took? Check this out. This is how my OBS is laid out now. Look at this. It's like I have the chat, like, right here. Oh, I can't even highlight that. Here, let me get a red pen. I have my chat right here. I have my scenes right here. My sources are right underneath it. This is my preview window. This is where I see all my audio. This is where I can look at my redeems that I could check off to know that I've already done them. This is my activity feed. So I know, like, when I get, like, activity, like raids and what have you, down here is where I can see where I'm, like, beginning to die. Like, when this green box, when that turns red like this, that's when I start to cry and end my stream. Yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. But it used to be vertical, but so I'm getting used to this. I'm getting used to this. Ron, you're so big brain. Yeah, thanks, guys. I am very big brain. I'm just so good at doing stuff that I like to do. Isn't that interesting? Oh, anyways, I gotta play some music because my life is nothing without music. So, if you guys don't mind, I'm gonna play a song called 10 degrees Celsius because I'm eating something really cold. It makes me feel like that. This song is called 10 degrees Celsius. I'm gonna be playing this during the empty sound sections of my stream. Anyways, hi. I remember when you forgot to save your relax time. I know, I did that and I freaking cried. I cried so hard. I'm eating Sprite. Yes, I'm eating it. I'm not drinking Sprite, I'm eating it. You can't drink something that's solid if I last remember. Wow. Okay. It's absolutely a crunchy drink. Okay, I'm muting it. Check it out what I have so far. So, if you guys remember last time I was mixing on something, Ron upset but also enjoying Frozen Sprite. Yeah, I'm a mixture of a lot of emotions. Anyways, this song is called The Glory Days. It's by Supercell. And I'm mixing it for Nyadia, who is an Australian cat girl VTuber. She's really cool. One of my good friends in the community here. I'll shout her out. She recently re-debuted, and she looks older, so it's pretty cool. She's like One-san mode or whatever you call it. So that's pretty cool. So yeah, I'm mixing it for her, and yeah, she's upside down VTuber. She says VTuber like VTuber. Anyways, so I'm mixing it. I have like a lot of stuff here. Let me mute the music and let me hear what her voice sounds like. Anyways, I got a lot of stuff done. So if, as you can see here, the voice tracks that are like this lime green color and sometimes blue, these are the ones that are already mixed, and the ones that are like some off, like, you know, I don't even know what these are. Fragilities, thanks for the follow. Welcome to the stream. And these other colors here, like this one here, is some other. I don't even know what even to describe these colors. It's like, it's not this color. These are the raw files, so I'm gonna be turning them into actually these green ones. So we'll see when we get there, guys. So I'm gonna be working on this. This is commissioned. So let's jump right in. All right, let's listen to it. Let's listen to it with the music this time. I hope this song doesn't get me DMCA, that would kind of suck. Mounduk, no! She's not gonna die because she has the mom hairstyle. Alright, so that's pretty much like the first chorus that I have mixed so far. And then I have this part in the middle. I'm gonna mix it in a little bit better. But that's pretty much where we are right now. Let's get some more mixing down. Blech. Dun, 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 dun. How are you guys' day so far? By the way, some news that I haven't said before. Since the last time I streamed. You guys know I work at McDonald's, right? My McDonald's lobby has been closed for like the longest time, which means like customers can't come in. to, like, you know, use the bathroom or even, like, order on the front counter or whatever, right? This week, like, on Monday, we actually, you know, opened the front lobby. It's been closed for so long. I had no idea why. And I don't know. I guess it's, like, you know, obviously store policy and stuff like that. And I guess whatever the store owner decides to say, what you want to do. Risky business, yeah. But, like, this week, we actually opened up our doors, finally. You know? A lot of customers have been complaining, and I guess we just did it, you know? Risky business. It is definitely risky, because, you know, COVID's still out there, right? But I think it's because most people are vaccinated in my city now, which is, you know, a good sign. It's also, like, the mandates of whatever states and what have you, you know? You can... where not have to wear masks anymore if you're fully vaxxed or whatever. Real question, why wouldn't you use drive-thru? Drive-thru's been open since the beginning. Ever since the pandemic came out in, like, February to, like, the lockdown in March, you know, I've continued to work at Mickey D's, and the drive-thru has always been an option, you know? People, honestly, like, this week, people are still adjusting, because, like, we've had our doors closed for so long that people just think that the, we're only still drive-thru, so, honestly, like, we're getting a lot of people still thinking that we're, like, closed, but in reality, there's, like, a big sign that says, hey, our doors are open now, yay, you know? People really want to sit down that much? You know, I don't know, I guess. You know, if they're out... What's really weird is that my McDonald's off of a highway, so, like, people usually just come in and go out, like, anyway, so it's up to them. See what I need to work on. I think I want to work on... Oh, yeah, I recently got some more harmonies right here, so I think I want to refine some of that. True. Slushies. Yeah, dude, actually, yo, I've been really experimenting. This whole week, I've been experimenting with, like, frozen sodas as, like, popsicles or just, like, frozen drinks, you know? So, the first drink I tried was root beer. Bad choice. Don't freeze root beer and eat it. It actually tastes terrible, in my opinion. I love root beer. It's one of my favorite drinks to drink. But when it's frozen, ugh. Ugh, it doesn't hit very good, to be honest. And then after that, I tried Coke. Coke's okay, because Coke already has, like, a slushy. You know, I'm used to Coke being a slushy. You know, you go to, like, 7-Eleven, you know, they'll have, like, a slushy Coke, or even, like, a movie theater sometimes. Yeah. And then, this one, I've tried it with Sprite, right? So, Sprite's really good. I really enjoy Sprite. I feel like any clear drink would be pretty, bussin', if I do say so. I think this one right here, right? So, let's go here. So, I want to know, like, what drinks are, like, compatible? Is that the word? Like, what do they taste good frozen? Like, which drinks taste good frozen? You know what I mean? I know Sprite's good. I love Sprite. You like the spicy Sprite, son? Son, have you tried frozen Sprite, though? I'm eating one right now. It's, like, mostly melted because, like, I ate all the ice. So I'm, like, mostly, like, I would say it's, like, 90% I'm drinking it and, like, 10% I'm eating it. You're thrussy, huh? That's disgusting. Sprite and Coke. Yeah, I feel like Sprite and Coke are probably, like, the best for, like, as frozen. I kind of want to try Dr. Pepper, like, frozen. Like, how good would that be? Would it be good? Also, thanks for the follow. Kanashi. The Zacian? Zacian? I don't even know. I wonder what Fanta's like. Fanta's probably pretty good, too, to be honest. So, okay, son. So, I work at McDonald's, right? Right before I end my shift, I go home, right? They send me home, like, Ron, you can go home now. I'm like, yeah, thank you, you know? I could just take a drink. Drinks are free for all the employees that work there. So I'll just go to the ABS, which is automatic beverage dispenser or whatever it means. And I'll just dispense myself a large, you know, soda with no ice. And I'll just do that. I take it home, pop it in the freezer. Boom. Got myself a frozen fizzy drink. Yeah, what's up, Kanashi? How you doing? What brings you here? You like music? You like funny? That's too bad. You're not going to get any. Yeah, I said it. Okay. You're doing good. You're doing well. That's good to hear. That's good to hear. I'm doing some tuning stuff right now. So, if you guys don't mind. Ron, you should just get a gym bag of just soda and freeze it. A gym bag? Ha! Your volume is full? Well, that's too bad. Okay. Let's put this... Where do I put this? I need my vocal files. Which is right here. There it is. I need to put this right here. Alright. Where is... Is this the one right here? Your ears hurt? That's too bad. Yeah, this is the part. Okay. Aww. Thanks for the pet. Hey, Shonen. How you doing? That's my laugh when I talk to people in real life, guys. You wouldn't know. You never met me in real life. Mm-hmm. All right, I'm going to denoise this. Good peachy. I'm a good peachy. All right, I denoise this. And let's bring it on over to my pitch correction. I'm going to make her sound like a god. Let's go. Check it out. This is where I make people's voices sound like they sound like they sing it perfectly the first time. I mean, I'm not saying Nyadia is a bad singer. She's a very excellent singer. Have you guys seen her karaoke streams? Very good at singing. I think she was actually in what's that show that VTubers are in? It's like American Idol, but like not American Idol. You know what I mean? It's with Waifu Baby. What's it called again? It's called Starstruck. Yeah, Starstruck. I think Nadia, what's the word? Applied? Is that what you call it? Auditioned. Sorry, there's a lot of words going through my head right now. So yeah, she auditioned for it, I think. I don't know if she went up already or she's yet to be, you know, on it, but we'll see. But Nadia is a very good singer. Audition apply. Here, I'll shout her out again. If you guys want to follow the person that I'm mixing, there she is. She's Australian. She's a cat girl. She has pink hair. She's pretty cool. And she's funny. And she also appears on my stream every now and then. Alright. But yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. What's up, Dream SMP fan? How are you doing? You take your normal pills today? I took my normal pills, did you? Come on, man. That's what the mask's for. I'm doing some mixing for today. I'm an audio engineer, if you didn't know. It was my secret this whole time. You guys never knew. It's like my side hustle. I do this in my free time, you know? It's not like I get monetary value from this or anything. Definitely don't do this professionally. You ran out of normal pills? Man, that sucks. Hopefully you get a new prescription. I'm pretty good though. Today was a pretty hot day. That kind of... Yeah, I'm not really a fan of hot weather, so... I didn't like it that much. But... I can't deny that it was a nice day today, but... It was just really hot, so I stayed inside. But I worked at Mickey D's. I kind of like fall, to be honest, Mountain Dew. Like winter's pretty cool, but I don't like snow. Like, I don't like super heat. I also not a fan of, like, super cold. But snow is pretty cool, but, like, I don't like how snow, like, is very, like, inconvenient. Because I drive, right? So, like, I don't like it that much. Bye, Dream fan. See you later. They're probably gonna go buy some more normal pills. But what's up, Akamitsu? How you doing? I think after I'm done, like, with my session, like, editing a little bit, I think I kind of want to, like, play a little bit of Minecraft. Baby. So guys, if you're unaware, you know how like Twitch has Twitch teams? You know, they're either for like networking or I don't know, maybe it's a social status, who knows, you know? Like, oh my gosh, guys, I'm in VSW, whatever it's called. I can talk to the cool VTubers, guys. Guys, I'm in VSW, oh my gosh. It's like a social status or whatever. But I'm in a couple. I'm in Sugar Crush. That's ran by what's it called? What's her name again? Eye Candy. She's a partner. She's pretty cool. She's my first boss. She accepted me into Sugar Crush. And the one that I'm in right now that I guess I kind of am more active in by just because I check the notifications more often on that group. You guys can see it right now, right next to the title, I think. It's I'm in Kitsune Cafe. So Kitsune Cafe recently purchased a Minecraft server. And it's for the members who are in the group. So if you guys are a VTuber and you happen to also be in the Kitsune Cafe as a member, I feel like if I'm wrong, I don't know if I'm right or wrong or not, but like they have access to the server. So I guess it's like, it's kind of like a way for like, I would say like if I made like a Twitch group and I started a server for the group, I would be like, this would be a good way for people to, you know, I guess interact, maybe collaborate, you know, this could encourage like, maybe I could collaborate with some other, you know, streamer from Kitsune Cafe as well. You know, we have some other people in Kitsune Cafe. I know Twee is in Kitsune Cafe. I know that's actually about it. I kind of forget who's in Kitsune Cafe, to be honest. Hi, Steambub. That's a really cute emote, Akimitsu. Candy Art Senpai. Wow. Pink hair. I like people with pink hair. I like people with blue hair. Blue hair is one of my weaknesses as well. As you can see, I like Hatsune Miku. You drew me, Pandix? You drew me? Hi, Pandix. How do you say hello in Polish again? I forgot how to say hello. Hey, Google. How do you say hello in Polish? Oh yeah, Cześć. Cześć. Right? Cześć. I don't know how the consonants are spelled or like, you know, are said like, so I might be saying it wrong. Today's your third day of using Linux? What made you change to Linux? What was your first one, Windows or Mac? Windows. Why Linux? Is it because Steam Deck? Because Steam Deck's gonna run on Linux. You know, with what's it called, Proto Shell, something like that. But like Linux, aside from that, is I think it's like pretty good for like kind of like intro to how to like, I guess for coder people. The pain to set up. Yeah, is the penguin treating you well? But yeah, but Pandix, if you like drew me, I would love to see it. If you can put it in the in my Discord in the fan art tab. If you put it out of there and already, I don't know. Excuse me. Does that sound? It's really scratchy right here. It even looks scratchy. Look at that. It's like also like jagged edges right there. Hey Ron, I got a question. Hey Ron, I've got a question for ya. What inspires you to stream on Twitch? I can send it to your Twitter. Yeah, you can do that too. Have I saved? I'm going to save right now. I just saved. Thank you. Also, thank you for the host. Zach, I think, yeah, I mean, what inspires me to stream on Twitch? Well, first, it was like, I think for most people, it's like, you want to stream because you want to stream for your friends, right? That's how it usually is in the beginning for most people. But I started streaming because I thought it would be fun. I wanted to do more content creating because even before streaming, hang on, let me drink some Sprite. Even before streaming, I used to edit videos like for my YouTube channel, which I post there every now and then. It's kind of dead because I stream more than edit, but it's still there though. You can see my edited videos. And I decided, you know, I think it would be more interactive and more I would keep into touch with what's in the now by, you know, by streaming. Because, you know, when you're streaming, you can just do it live. You don't really need to edit stuff. And I thought it'd be kind of cool, you know? And I didn't start streaming until February last year in 2020. And let me see if this command works. Yeah, exclamation point rat. This is Yuxi, guys. It says right there, check out the first VTuber I watched on Twitch, Yuxiu. They inspired me to start streaming more often. They were playing Lost Ember at Twitch, .tv/Yuxiu. So, yeah, when I used to stream on YouTube, and I would only do stuff like this, basically, except more low quality. I don't even know if I even have the VODs anymore on YouTube, on my second channel. But I used to just do like just mixing, but like a lot more low quality. And then I moved to Twitch in February because I saw Yuxi streaming, and it was like before we even like knew each other. Like we were like not friends. It was like I just tuned in for the first time when I said my first word. I said, "What's going on in here?" And then after that, I started watching more. I started, you know, interacting with the community. I found out what, like, how to become a VTuber, essentially. You know, like, you don't need, like, a 3D avatar to be a VTuber. Guys, if you look at me right now, that little PNG guy, I've had this PNG since the very beginning. And I've been using it ever since. But I will upgrade eventually. I'll get there, you know? Just gotta spend money. You need money, guys. And I guess, you know, I like the interaction with the people. I like talking to people. I also just like the creativity that, you know, comes from streaming. You know, like, you can see, like, how different I was before. Or just learn Live 2D yourself. I could, or I could just pay someone else. It's just easier that way. I hate money. Can I have yours? If you hate it, you don't want it. Can I have it? Kind of cool. All right, what did Steambub said? He like posted like a paragraph. You've been meaning to move to Linux for a while. One major thing was holding me back was quick lack of NAS network file storage. Got a couple months back, and after I felt it one Linux distro, I just had a very fresh this week with another distro. Ooh, okay. But now like the whole free open source software movement, just like drop Windows and Linux gaming has major gains in the last few years. Cool. Hopefully Linux will treat you well in the future. We'll see. We'll see, like, maybe like next year, like Linux will have like a new like breakthrough and SteamOS can be like, ha, I used Linux before it was cool. It probably already is though, I don't even know. It's cool though. I think I'm all about convenience, and I feel like setting up like my own OS would be like kind of inconvenient to me. I'd just rather have something just pre-built for me, to be honest. Yeah, so just to wrap it up, my whole like streaming thing, I stream because it's fun, it's interactive, it's fun because I talk to people, I like talking, and it kind of gives me an excuse to play games, to be honest. And it's creative, I like being creative. A lot of new ways to show stuff on screen, and I like to utilize that to the best of my ability, you know? And I think eventually, one day, I want to teach you guys how to do it too, you know? How to be interactive on stream? Like, if you want to be a streamer too, like how I set up my redeems and how you can make your own or something? I don't know, that'd be kind of cool. And like, maybe tips and tricks on how to like make your stream like accessible to a wider audience? Like, I can say it right now. And I've said it many times before. Basically, if you're starting off, if you're like before you're an affiliate, or even you are an affiliate right now, like me, I would recommend don't stream at 1080p 60 frames per second. Like, please, like, it hurts me whenever I see that. The reason is because you're excluding a pretty wide audience, you know? Especially mobile users, which is actually like a lot. A lot of people are gonna be on mobile. Can't you choose your quality, Mountain Dew says? That's a good question. You can if you're a partner. If you're a partner, you can. Partners, 100% guaranteed, will always have encoding options. Affiliates will sometimes get encoding options, but it's kind of like a chance. It's like a flip of a coin. You might get it one stream once you start it for the first time, and then sometimes you won't get it at all. Yeah, so look, so Mountain Dewick says, but I can set your stream at 480p. That's because I was lucky enough as an affiliate to get encoding options. I don't always get encoding options. So I guess this time around, I was lucky enough to actually have them. So, you know, lucky me. You guys can downscale my stream so you actually view it on if you have like low bandwidth or something like that. Like you're going to be on a road trip or something and you're watching my stream on mobile data. But that's basically it. If you are streaming like high amounts of data, you're going to be losing viewers from maybe like people who don't have good internet for on their desktops, or even most likely mobile users. It hurts me so much. I see that mistake happen all the time, and I'm just like, man, I just want to tell them without being mean, you know? I just want to be like, dude, you got to stream at a lower frame. You got to, you know, 60 frames per second. Just do it at 30. It looks okay. Do it 720, dude. It looks okay. And it's fine. Hello, Hale. How come you're not watching Yuxi's, charity stream? She's going to save the trees, and I'm not. I'm killing the trees. What are you watching my stream for? Get out of here. Speaking of killing trees, I'm actually gonna do that when I play Minecraft later on today, I think. I'm kind of in a Minecraft mood, so. I'm gonna be playing on a vanilla Minecraft server that's run by the leader of Kitsune Cafe. Nah, I'm just kidding, Hale. I'm just joking. I'm just joshing. I'm just pulling your leg. I'm just yanking your chain. Okay, all my sprites are gone. I just drank all my Sprite. That Sprite's all gone. Yeah, but like, I started playing Minecraft today. It's pretty cool. I ran into a jungle, and I'm now in a birch forest at the moment. And while I was in the jungle, I also managed to tame a parrot, a red parrot, so. Pretty cool. Kind of excited because I usually never get parrots. Because like every single time I spawn on Minecraft, I'm never or like in a jungle. So I'm pretty excited that I actually managed to get one like this early. I love birds, guys. I love birds. Whoa, Tete, with the celery man. I bet Tete's in her seat right now, smirking so hard. She's going, yeah, yeah, yeah. Do you have other pets other than the evil dog? So my family only has one dog. We're basically dog sitting two other dogs. But so yeah, currently there's three dogs in the house. And there's only dogs. That's all we have, just dogs. How are you, baby? Baby, I give you a little kiss. Guys, say hi to Tete. Everyone say hi to Tete. Tete's here. Hi, Tete. Who's Tete? Yeah, who's Tete? I mean, hi. Mom, dude, you're so mean. You're okay? That's good to hear. Yeah, I'm just doing some commission work. Okay. So now I got everything cut up. Now I'm going to, bleh.
I'm gonna find out what I do it.
Alright, so as you can see on the other screen, I have my harmony guide right here. So I'm gonna follow these lines and to make it sound like she's singing the right note. So let's just jump right into it. Okay, let's see. Yeah. There we go. Boom. Okay. So that's the first line right there. Gotta adjust the timing here, so I gotta adjust these so the lines actually like match up with each other. That's how you get a good sounding song, you know. If you want to sound super robotic but still sound pretty good, not gonna lie, like the fact that I like timed the vocals to be almost exactly like of the beat of the song, it kind of it's a huge cheat, and it kind of sounds like impossible. It gets rid of like the naturalness of the voice, but you know, it does sound good in the end, so I don't really care. I'll only like not do it as precision like if they ask me not to. They'll be like, Ron, I want this to sound as natural as possible, and I'll be like, all right, I'll just wing it then. Oh, Nadia's here. Oh, good day, Nadia. Hello. Good day, mate. Shout out to Nadia. Guys, this is Nadia. Nadia is the person who's singing.
Hi, Nadia, hello.
Good day, mate. A round of applause for the Australian. Hello. Good day, cunt. Nah, that's not you, Nadia. That's not Nadia. Don't worry. I know you heard that, Nadia. You're not flat. It's just the quantization of the software makes it sound like it just snaps it to the nearest note, and it just happened to snap it on a note that made it sound like you were flat. I know what you're thinking. You're not, okay? It's just look what happens. There's a knob that you can't see right here. See this green knob? It's called center. Right? Look what happens when I leave it all the way to the other side, which means there's no centering attached, right? You can see this is where you actually sing the note. You actually, according to what I see right here, you actually sing it directly almost between the two notes. So you were neither on either whole note. You were directly in the middle. So I'm gonna now turn the knob all the way to the right so that it's on 100% center. It just happened to snap your vocal to the bottom note, which made it sound like you were flat. All right, if I turned it off, you would sound fine, but still not on the pitch. I was about to say, wow, I had the audacity to send you me singing flat. Dude, I wouldn't even mind it. I've heard worse, to be honest. My own voice. I'm just kidding. Actually, no, for real. Sometimes when I sing, I'll even notice. I'll be like, wow, I sing that pretty bad. And this is why I mix for myself. You know, and no one else mixes for me except for me. That's the beauty of being your own mixer, because you can just send your own bad vocals, and no one could, you know, be the wiser. You know, people think I'm a good singer. Get fooled, guys. I'm actually a really bad singer. I've been fooling you all these years, and you guys had no idea. You guys had no idea. Huh. Hey, Ron, Among Us.
When the imposter is sus.
How dare you said that? That's kind of sus, dude, bro. How you doing, Zoe? What brings you here today? Hello. G'day. It's me, Ronaldo. I remember one time, this is a story when I played World of Warcraft a long time ago. My name was Ronaldo, and everyone thought I was Brazilian. Like, I would get, like, international people playing, like, WoW, right? And, like, they'd probably be like Portuguese or something, because like who else would think I'm Brazilian because my name is Ronaldo, you know? Because like I know, because like there's a famous soccer player, I think from Brazil or Portugal or whatever, his name is Ronaldo, so I guess they associate my name with the famous soccer player, and I'm just like, no, I just like the name Ronaldo, you know? It's like you name yourself like something, I don't know. I'm just thinking of some generic Japanese name that you would name yourself as like a username. Like my name is Sakura. My name is Sakura Izunomaki or something. And it's like, oh my gosh, are you Japanese? It's like, do I
sound Japanese?
Oh, Pandix sent me a DM. All right, so if you guys don't, whoa. Why am I shirtless? Sakura? Is that a Japanese name? It is. Pandix, why am I shirtless? Please tell me I'm wearing pants at least. She drew me shirtless. That's I look good, but like why no shirt? Can I show this on stream? Bunny Rin-chan, thank you for the follow. And Jazz Niao, thank you for the follow as well. Poop. That's crazy. Like, yo, okay, look. So look, yeah, Bunny Rin-chan, right? Like, to me, that would be like a Japanese name or something. So like, I would be like, oh my gosh, Bunny Rin-chan, are you Japanese? Because your name is Rin-chan? Like, I don't know anyone else in the world except for Japanese people named Rin. You know Rin Kagamine? Are you a Vocaloid? I would be like that. I'd be like that, you know? Ugh. Hi, Wisp. Sea Monkey Official? Wowzers, what's up? I am live. Hello. Because you didn't want to draw clothes, but you wanted to draw me shirtless? I feel like it would have been easier to draw clothes. But, you know, I don't know you. I don't know you're probably, like, more specialized to draw no clothes. So, that's fine, you know? Let me, I'm gonna pull it up. Do you mind if I pull it up? Pedix, can I show people? Can I show people? I'm gonna open up my Twitter. All right, ready? Can I show it, Pandix? Do I have your permission to show this fan art me shirtless? Do I even need to ask permission? I don't know. I just feel like the fact that I don't have a shirt on, I need to ask, you know? It's as if like, you know, you want to like knock on the door before you walk into someone's room cuz they might be like naked, right? So okay, I'm going to show it. Guys, check us out. Give me 1 second. Let me switch the window. Check it out, guys. This is me shirtless. Ooh. Oh, I did that. Wow. It's pretty good. Look at me, guys. I'm just going to Wild Waves. I'm just going to my local water theme park. I'm wearing shorts. I like the background though. The background looks really cool. Zoe, that's how you know I'm a real anime boy. Real anime boys don't have nipples. That's how you know I'm a real anime boy. Mixer. Yeah, that name is place is kind of convenient. Yeah. You picked an odd time to follow. Hello, Mika Mischief. You're so mischievous. How you doing, Mika? Welcome to the stream. Thanks for the follow, by the way. I'm just kind of chilling, doing my mixing commissions. What are you doing? What made you click the follow button, You're a tanuki and it's in your blood? Wow, you're a tanuki? That must mean you're Japanese. I'm just kidding. I'm just talking about something from earlier. You're a tanuki, oh my gosh. Is tanuki a trash panda? No, I feel no. Tanukis are. They are like. They're technically. What are they called? They're called. They're raccoon dogs. They're raccoon dogs from Japan. So, like, I guess they're part trash, but, like, they're not entirely trash because they got a little bit of dog in them. We are called raccoon dogs, but not all raccoons. It's like squares can be rectangles, but not all rectangles can be squares, right? Is that like the same thing? Elite trash. Hang on. I just lost my train of thought when I listened to that. What was that? I think I just timed that wrong, to be honest. Sorry, that made my brain shut down. I was trying to find the beat of the song. What am I listening to? Hang on, let me listen to this. I love you here in your so I love it here and you're so cute. Thanks, Bunny Rin-chan. I try my best. Ugu. Ha, that's me being cute. Yeah. Pretty cool, right? Hang on, give me one second. I need to listen to this real quick. I don't know what's happening at this part of the song, so I need to listen. Alright. Okay, then I compare. Zoe, I'm gonna call you out right now. You're being kind of annoying by saying stuff that's not on topic. So you're being kind of weird right now, to be honest. So if you could stop doing that, please. If you continue to do it, I'm gonna time you out for 10 minutes. And then after 10 minutes, you keep doing it. I'm just gonna like time you out for the whole day. And if you come back the next day, you keep doing it, I'm just gonna ban you. No balls. Okay, I'm warning you. Okay, so. Where is this? Where am I? Hang on. I don't know where I am in this vocal anymore. Okay, Natsuno. Okay, that's good. Next verse is over here. Did I pick the wrong harmony? Cause I'm actually like legitimately confused. Is it this one right here? Oh, I found it. I got it, guys. We did it. Ah, we did it, guys. I was just mixing the wrong thing the whole time. That face when. All right, new song. So I was looking at this file, right? So I'm just looking at this. I for some reason grabbed this part, which is in a later chorus. This is from a later chorus. I had to grab the one all the way here in the beginning because this technically is the first part of the chorus, which I'm at there right now. So I just grabbed it. I don't even know why. So let me just denoise this. Get the noise out of there. It's 7:30 a.m. so I must go to work. Have a good day at work, Pandix. Also, thank you for the fan art. I really like it. I'm gonna put that on my wall when I find some more space. Have a good day at work. Bye. Yep, there it is. Let's bring it out to here. I'm just gonna ditch the last one. And let's go. Here we go. Oh yeah, speaking of, I forgot to mention, I wanted to mention this because sometimes you guys like to jump around on my screen, right? You know how like you can like sometimes like jump and like be, remember when I had the slideshow, you could like jump and like be in the slideshow? You can technically jump and be like in the chat. If you jump at the right angle, there's like an open window you can jump through. So let me show you. If I go to this window, right? Also, Billgreave, the Red Ogre, hello, welcome to the stream. You said cheese. I'm lactose intolerant, I'm sorry. So, you see the chat up there right above me? You can actually technically jump in there. So, like, if I turn this on, show you the collisions, you can see that little window, like, right here. If you, like, angle yourself correctly, you can somehow jump in there and just be in the chat box. I don't know if it also works in the other scene. I don't know where the window is. It's actually pretty close still. So, that's kind of precise. Well, you gotta figure it out, you know? You gotta jump in there. Like, check it out. I can just drag myself in here because I'm cheating. But I'm not going to do it. Yeah, so just to let you guys know that that's an option, you know? If you guys ever want to, like, if you're bored. Look, guys, it's Belgrave, the Red Ogre. I found him. Check it out. I'm going to toss him to the side. There you go. And there's Kida and Carlos. There's no Jason. Foulface. And this is Witcheroo. And this is Pendix. And this is Bing Cortana, that's a good name. Zoe there. There's Kaji. There's Shiny Rays. Look at all these people. Look, I found Fiskiful. What the dog doing, dude? What the dog doing right now, man? I don't even know.
What the dog doing?
Anyways.
That's enough.
He said, ouch. That means you're vulnerable. You're showing weakness right now.
That's enough, so loud.
I thought Ogre is supposed to be big and strong.
That's not enough, so allow me. Not enough.
How'd you get the name Belgrave the Red Ogre? That's kind of like a very specific type of name, I would say. Like, Belgrave the Red Ogre. Like, that has to have some sort of backstory. Or it could just be like that one instance where you're just like, you know what? I'm going to be called Belgrave the Red Ogre from now on. You know? Yeah, and affected, I killed him.
Not enough, so not enough, so
it's from a manga? Belgrave, the Red Ogre, is from a manga? Crazy. Wow. Are you a manga character? Is there a real life manga character in my chat right now? Bro, how'd you do that? You are going turbo right now. Guys, watch Wreck-It Ralph? He's going turbo. He left his manga book and now he's appearing on streams. What manga is that from? If it's from something, I never read it probably. Yeah, they'd be like, I like how you guys are laughing at this, like freaking like time stretching and all that sounds, but like to me, this, I'm not even fazed by this anymore. Like, it was funny the first time when I first started mixing, like years ago, like a decade ago when I first started mixing in 2011, dude. I thought doing this was like, I was like, yeah, that's so funny. But now I'm just like, yeah, this is work. This is what work sounds like, and I'm not even fazed about it. It's not funny to me. But if it's funny to you, it's okay. I'm not saying it's not funny, Neo. I'm not saying stop laughing. It's okay. You can laugh. It's okay. Yeah, it's only work, no fun. You find it absolutely hilarious. It actually is sometimes in some aspects. There's some TikToks that I've seen every now and then where like they actually like use time stretching and stuff like that, and they make it kind of funny. Let me see if I can find one. Hang on. I'm gonna search TikTok. Let me show you a few TikTok. Time meme? What is this? No, not the pictures. What in the world? Ew, what the? Ew, I don't like that picture. Ew. I do not want to show you guys what I'm seeing right now. I'm just seeing, like, the worst pictures. Yeah, these pictures are disgusting. I'm just seeing, like, a bunch of pictures of people's warped faces. I'm just like, that is not human, and I don't like it. Yeah, never mind. I'm not going to show you anymore. I can't find any. I thought I would find it and show you right away, but it took me a long time, and I'm not going to find it anymore. Hey Nadia, you're ending your stream soon, but you still have some time to stream. What do you want to do for the rest of the evening? Oh, you want to watch videos? What kind of videos? Meme. Oh, you want to watch meme videos? Okay. It's worse when they speak English too. Like whenever I'm mixing someone that like speaks English, like you can definitely like just make up like any word they say because it's more familiar. And there's just so much like sounds you can make in English that you can do like that's not in Japanese. It's just like more consonants basically. I'm like in focus mode right now. That's why I'm a little bit silent. I'm just like, I just want to get this done. I just want to like cut this part and then just tune it. And like, that's what I want to do. Literally, like this, what I'm doing right now is basically like, this is the most time consuming part of the entire mixing process for me. Like, people have like their own ways of doing it. Like, I feel like most like tuners, like whoever like offers like tuning commissions, they'll probably be using like Melodyne or something like that. I don't offer tuning commissions. I think that's dumb. I just do it all in one. I don't offer it as a separate thing because I don't even want people to like mess with my tuning anyway. It's just how I do it, right? Hi, Sean. And he's lurking, and I will not ask him how his day was because he's not here anymore. Oh, by the way, I wanna try something, guys. I recently found like a video. Like trend on YouTube. Let me see if I can find it real quick. It's basically like the premise is it's the whole video is just a single frame of like anything. My day has been good, but you're in class right now? Oh, okay. Study hard. All right. Let me show you what I'm talking about. All right. I'm on YouTube right now. Check it out. I watched this video. It's called 1 Hour of Silence Broken Only by Random Among Us. And it's not just like the Among Us sound effect. It could be like any sound effect. It's just like, it's kind of nerve-wracking, to be honest. Just to like having this at full volume and just like you'll be doing something like throughout the day, forget this thing is even on, all of a sudden, Among Us! You know? Just out of nowhere, and it freaks me out. Set title, I'm no longer eating a Sprite slushie right now. Man. I should do Vine Boom. I feel like that would be funny. I love the Vine Boom sound effect. Oh, this picture of Mario. Alright, that was the first one. Sometimes they timestamp it. That's too often together. Now that's too often. Like, that's too often. Like for the Among Us one, they at least spread it out like several minutes before one comes in. It gets better. Nah, look, see, look, some guy timestamps every single like Among Us instances. I like it better when it's more sparsely like throughout the video, not like one after another after like a couple of seconds. It has three back to back followed by minutes. Okay. Back to the Vine boom. Let's just jump like 2 minutes in. Okay. I just want to make sure. Okay. All right. I'm just gonna leave this on the background. Okay. Let's keep working. This is gonna keep me on my toes. What's even worse? Cause like someone recommended, and I kind of want to try it. We're like, you'll have it on your phone. And you'll just put it under your pillow at full volume. And all of a sudden, like, just while you're sleeping, just like... Oh, that was perfect! What in the world? I was about to explain it, and I didn't even press any buttons. I was like, blah, blah. What? What are the odds? That was perfect. That was crazy. I feel so powerful right now. I feel like nothing can stop me anymore. I feel like it's not scaring me enough. For me, it's just like it plays. I'm just like, oh. I feel like the Among Us one scared me more, to be honest. It also probably helped that I was literally like on the computer in complete silence. Jeez. Okay, let's tune this now. Or time it, I guess, at the same time. Let's go. Let's actually turn on like an actual like song now. I don't want to listen to these royalty free Dova Syndrome music. I want to listen to instrumentals of music. I want to sing. How about this one? This is a good song. Let's see. Dude, today was like really busy. Like right before I ended my shift in McDonald's, like we had like a huge rush that caused me to basically like stay back an extra half an hour that I was like originally off. So like I'm off at work at 5. I didn't even leave until like 5:30. What happened was we had a customer order 20 McChickens. There's an instrumental for Ado. There is. Ado song Odo. There's an instrumental. It's really good. I'm thinking about singing it, guys. Hampanada KO. But I don't have time to sing it right now, so. Because I'm busy with commission work. Ooh, wow, wow, wow. Ooh, wow, wow. Odori dase, odori dase. The song bumping though, I love the song so much. Like, I'd be listening to the song like in the shower and I'd be freaking breaking it down. Tete knows what it looks like when I break it down. Tete, you know my breakdown power, dude. You know I throw it back. Tete knows. Tell him, Tete. Tell him what you know. Tell him that you know that I can throw it back. I can throw it back so well, guys. Trust me. Tete can vouch. I throw back on Tete so often. Tete knows. Tete feels bad, man. Tete's like, yeah, Ron throws it back at me all the time. It's getting to a point where it's affecting my health. It's affecting me nutritionally. It affects my nutrition. He even drew it on my whiteboard. I did. I was like, right before I left, I drew, because Tete has a whiteboard that I bought for her on Christmas, and we just draw like little doodles every now and then. She usually puts notes and stuff on there, and whenever I come by, I usually draw something, right? The first thing I drew when I visited a few times was I drew Tete's little blob girl, little blob thing, right? I drew it, it was really cute, and then the second time I visited, I added really sharp nails to it, because during my Final Fantasy wedding with Tete, Tete, I had no idea, because like she's a Lalafell and she's so small, but like when it got to the part where like the scene showed a close up of the ring, or like the rings coming onto her fingers, I saw Tete's like super sharp like tiger nails, and I was like, what is that? Why are you wearing like super long like tiger like manicured nails? Like, it took me aback. I was like, what in the world? So when I visited Tete, I drew like super long like just claws on the little blob Tete that I drew. And then yesterday when I visited Tete, I went ahead and drew myself twerking on her whiteboard. So it's always gonna be on there. She's gonna wake up in the morning trying to like find out like her notes to see what she has to remind her to do. And she's gonna see me just like, I'm just throwing it back on there. Anyways, I wanna play a different song now. Exactly. Oh my gosh, he's streaming. Hey, what's up, dude? You're from India, or a section of it. If only we were all so blessed. Alright, here's the pictures. This is the picture. Look, this is the picture that I drew on Tete on her whiteboard. Look at that. See? I drew myself twerking. And then this is her lemon thing, and then I drew the tiger nails on it. There it is. don't mind the other words you see. Mr. Worldwide, that's me. Hey, Dolly, Mr. Worldwide, this is 305. Come. Ooh. Alright, everything's timed, I think, now, right? Or am I wrong? I think I just finished timing everything. Everything looks to be online. Yeah, I'm good. That's time to tune. It's tune time. Yeah. Fisk? Oh my gosh, Fisk is here. Is that the Ron's World Underscore, the professional McDonald's meal reviewer? Fisk, did you see my tweet that I put out? It was like my opinion on like the whole like celebrity meal thing. It was like my stance on it. Cause like I've been through it all ever since the Travis Scott meal came out. I've been through every single one of them, and I've seen how well they've, you know, brought sales to McDonald's. I would say BTS is probably gotta be, it's a close second, you know. I feel like Travis Scott did a really good job, because he was the first BTS meal. He was the first celebrity meal, and freaking, we got so many hype beasts coming out for the Travis Scott meal. He always got his meal sold, like every single day. Travis Scott meal, Travis Scott meal, Travis Scott meal. And then BTS meal would be a good second place, I feel like. It would come around every now and then, but people would be like, why would you get the BTS meal? It's just 10-piece nugget. It's literally all it is. But like, it's just the sauce that it comes with it. The Cajun sauce and the sweet chili sauce. And then I can see that the other ones that come out, So there's four that's out right now. Travis Scott, I'm gonna say it in order. Travis Scott, J Balvin, BTS, and then Saweetie. And in order from popularity, it would be probably BTS, Travis Scott, J Balvin, and then Saweetie, whoever Saweetie is. I don't even know who she is either. I did some research. She's an American rapper, and apparently one of my coworkers told me this. She's girlfriend of some other person named Quaver. So if you know who Quaver is, then you might know who Saweetie is. But I have never heard Saweetie in my entire life until this meal came out. Apparently, she's like known for like her weird food combinations. So that's why she has like a McDonald's name, because it's kind of like, there's a picture of her like circulating on the internet where she's just drizzling like her like sweet and sour on her Big Mac. I don't really know. Like, there's also like a pamphlet that like comes out with it. Yeah, his name's Quaver. It's some dude. I don't know. I don't even know, man. It is what it is. Oh, jeez. By the way, if you guys just came into my stream and you guys are hearing random, like, Vine Boom sound effects, I'm watching a video called Complete Silence, except, like, every now and then a Vine Boom sound effect will play. So I'm listening to that right now. They literally play without me knowing. I don't know. It's like making me really nervous and anxious. I don't think Maka's Ozzy had the Travis Scott meal. I only know about the BTS meal. Yeah, BTS is more, I think, worldwide, I think. Like, it was out in like Singapore and everything. They don't know the Fortnite burger. Okay. I'm tuning now. Whoa. Was the sicko mode burger yum? It was a normal burger. Literally, the only thing. So the Travis Scott burger. Let me just talk about the Travis Scott burger. New Flip Redeem. I've had it. So the Travis Scott burger is literally just a normal quarter pounder with cheese. And he adds shredded lettuce and bacon. That's all the burger is. And the other parts of the meal is a Sprite, which you can change to any other drink you want. Thank you, Vine Boom. And barbecue sauce with fries. That's all it is. And so, like, I'm saying it was really good because... It was the fact of how cheap it was. Whoa! Fisk, thank you for gifting 3 community subs to my channel. I really appreciate it, Fisk. Thank you so much. Oh my gosh. Money just for me? I'm gonna buy a Saweetie meal and review it on stream. I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna waste my time eating a Saweetie meal. But thank you so much. Oh my gosh. If you guys got a gift sub, say thanks. Money! But yeah, the Travis Scott meal was cheap. That was the only thing why it was so good. Because like a normal quarter pounder meal, like a normal one, would be like $8.56 for the whole meal. Like a medium size number 2, which is the quarter pounder meal with fries and a drink, whatever. It would be like $8.56, right? But a Travis Scott meal would be $6. Like how insane is that? And he even adds bacon and shredded lettuce, which would cost extra if you add it onto the normal burger. So that's why it was so crazy. It was just like so cheap. It was such a good deal to just buy the Travis Scott meal and remove the lettuce and the bacon, and you would just get like a normal number 2, and it would be cheaper by like almost a full $2.50. It was insane. It was such a good thing. So that's why the Travis Scott meal for me was like it was like a good deal, because it was just so cheap. It was crazy. Let's see, I want some of this now. BTS meal is just, it's literally just a normal 10-piece meal. Nothing special, it's just a sauce, really. And the packaging's kind of cool, I guess. If you're a BTS fan, honestly, like, I said, I can understand. Because, like, if McDonald's collaborated with, like, Kizuna Ai, you know I'd be collecting those packages. If Kizuna Ai had, like, her branding on, like, the freaking, like, wrappers, bro. I know how they feel. Because, like, if I... obviously, if your idol like collaborated with something that you're like, you know, you don't even care about, you would want to collect something because it's good memorabilia. So like, I understand that much. I can understand the BTS people out there collecting like the BTS boxes, BTS bags, BTS freaking nuggets and not even eating them because it's cool or whatever. I don't even know. Freaking Kizuna eye sauce. Bro, can I get one Kizuna eye sauce meal, please? Yo, can I get the Kizuna meal? Thank you so much. Bro, I would love the Kizuna eye meal. It'd be so cool. But yeah, it's literally, the celebrity meals are just stuff that celebrities would order at McDonald's if they did go to McDonald's. And that's basically it. It could be simple. It could be like a little bit. It could introduce more stuff. I don't even know. To be honest, I doubt BTS even eats 10-piece nuggets. It was just like an excuse to add new sauce. Maybe. I don't know. I'm not BTS. You know, freaking speed L BTS right now. What would the Kizuna eye meal even be? Okay, but I like the Cajun sauce. Me too, solely. I like the Cajun sauce. Not gonna lie. Like, do you guys remember like when the Szechuan sauce came back because like of the whole like, was it because of the Mulan movie or was it because of Rick and Morty? It was either one of those two. They brought back Szechuan sauce because of one of those promotions. I forget what it is. But Szechuan sauce was kind of cool, I guess. It didn't even taste like anything to me. It was just like a different sweet and sour, to be honest. I don't know. That's an awesome. It was something. I literally forgot. I remember. It was Rick and Morty. Rick and Morty brought it back. Oh, yeah, because they talk about it in that one episode. So I'm not sure if like McDonald's is even associated with that, but like I feel like it's a little bit of both, to be honest. That's an awesome. Yeah, so like now with the BTS, with the new like Cajun sauce with the sweet chili sauce, it's kinda like, you know, introducing some other new sauce you could dip your nuggets into or French fries. I don't even know. That's awesome. It was kinda cool, to be honest. Like my McDonald's location still has the Cajun sauce. Like if you ask for it, like it's not listed. But if you ask for it, we probably still have it and you can still get it. So even today, I saw an order still have Cajun sauce on it. So, you know, customers are still definitely asking for it still. They definitely brought it back because somehow it just probably the episode got. Yeah, I mean, Szechuan sauce, bro. Dude, you go on eBay right now. I bet you can find Szechuan sauce still being sold somewhere. Just like an old one. What are you talking about? I think he's speaking the language of the gods. Ron, I'll pay you the 15 cents. Share that sauce. I'm glad you know the price of the sauce at my store. I'm glad the things I teach you guys remain in your brain. You can tell it to your parents. Be like, oh, Shiny, what'd you learn today? McDonald's sauce costs extra 15 cents. Like, how'd you know that? You don't even work at McDonald's. Like, I watch Ron's Work Underscore. Don't you know? I watch Ron's Work Underscore. All right, have a good one, Tete. Rest well. I kiss you. Mwah. Guys, I love Tete so much. She's the best girl ever, guys. If you were in my shoes, you guys would know the blessed feeling of being Tete's significant other. It's the best. It's the best. Yeah, I hope Tete feels better. Tete just works hard and she feels the pain of working hard, to be honest. That freaking you wish sauce costed 15 cents in Australia. Do you know how much it costs in Australia right now? I don't work at Macca's in Aussie land. It's 50 cents each? Bro, for 50 cents, you can get like 3 sauces at my store. 3. That's pricey, dude. Soft serve cone is 70 cents. Okay, that's cheap though. A soft serve cone in my store, like after tax, would cost $1.51. So I guess that's more pricey over here. Don't know why. It just is. I don't make the prices. Maybe we're just more rich here. I don't know. Hell no. Yeah, it's really expensive. Oh, by the way, Nadia, this note right here, it's supposed to be down here, but I think for now I'll just leave it up there because I feel like the other one that I tuned on the other one is also up here as well. So I'm just going to keep it up there because just the way you sang it. You know, I'm not going to make you sing perfectly like the other singers. Like, this is your cover. You have to sing like you, Nadia. This is your cover, Nadia. You have to own it. What note is compatible? Just go to Australia and stockpile on 70 cent cones. Yeah, I'll bring it back to the States and I'll just save them for later. That's genius. Why didn't I think of that? Just keep them in the cooler. Freaking like buy a lifetime supply of just 70 cent cones from Australia and just keep it throughout the entire year I'm in the States, bro. Imagine if that was like how you do it, you know? I was like, welcome back, Ron. What, you know, you come to Australia every now and then, but I never asked you why you visit. Ron, why are you here in Australia? 70 cent cones. What? 70 cent cones. Freeze them and send them over, but it wouldn't be soft serve anymore. It'd be hard serve. They would turn hard. When you freeze them, they'll just be hard again. I want soft serve, not hard serve. Who do you think I am? What note is this? Supposed to be a C. This is a good song, Atomic Kaibo. If you guys want to listen to me cover the song, it's on my YouTube. It's on my YouTube. I sang the song, but only half of it. I want to sing the full one eventually, but you know, busy, like I said. Oh, by the way, I don't know why that reminded me, but when I visited Tete yesterday, her roommate recently, or not recently, I guess, but he, a long time ago, bought like a small amount, like I think 6 or 8, was it like 8 packs? He bought the curry cup noodle ramen, like the instant noodle, and it was the curry flavor because he wanted to try it. And I was like, this flavor is so good, it's so good. But then when I visited, I found out that he actually doesn't like them anymore. So that means like I can have them, I can have all of them. So I brought some home, and I also ate one when I was over there. And bro, I am happy. Dude, if you've never tried the curry flavor cup noodle ramen, it's really good. I recommend it. But it does make your mouth smelly, and you will be tasting curry for like the next couple of hours after you eat it. Why no full cover? Because at the time, you know, when you sing a song, cause like I'm as a my own self mixer, I'm kind of like the type where like I'll sing a line and then immediately mix it into the cover. So while I was singing it, I was like, you know what? I already have like half the song done and I'm kind of lazy to finish the whole thing. So I might as well just like release what I've got so far, you know? So that's why I sang a short version of the song, because I was just lazy. But I'm planning to sing more of it, you know? I'm trying this new method of recording for music where I'll just record first, mix later. That way I can actually have more of my vocals ready and, you know, not have to literally wait for myself, you know what I mean? It's also like more time efficient, because like when you sing and mix at the same time, it takes daylight goes by so fast, and by the time I'm like near like the middle of the song, it's probably like nighttime and I can't sing anymore. So that's why I'm like lazy, because like I just can't sing when it's nighttime because my family's sleeping, right? So that's like another reason why I didn't finish it. So if you sing all the lines like when it's still like daylight and when everyone's active, you can still mix at night because you're not bothering anyone. It's just you and your headphones listening or whatever in your studio. But you can't sing though, because singing is loud. So that's why you should sing first, mix later. That's gonna be my new rule. That's my new rule, guys. You gotta mix first. Sing first, mix later. What is this song? I don't know what the song. Let's listen to an Utaite classic. Singing is loud, can confirm. Yeah, Shiny Ray sings so much and everyone's like, shut up! Shiny, stop singing! Udasai! Finding time to sing without having my cat meowing in the background or my fiance yelling in his room is hard. That is true. You know what you could do? Either tell your fiance to be like, babe, can we schedule a time where I can, you know, sing and you shut up? And then he'll be like, yes, honey. With like his like sad face, he'd be like, yes, honey. It's like, babe, it's 4 p.m. It's singing time. Yes, honey. Or whatever. I don't even know when you sing. And then just, I don't know, give your cat some catnip and have a trip out somewhere, I don't know. Yes, honey. Exactly. You have to communicate with your partner, Nyaria. That's one of the first, like, steps of having a healthy relationship. Communication. You gotta communicate, girl. Trip out trying to drug a cat. Yeah, ever heard of catnip? It's like a natural type of like, it's like I don't know, weed. It's like weed for cats. I don't know. I don't have a cat, so I'm not sure. I do not own a feline. I only own dog. I'm trying to get rid of the auto-tune sound. Okay. I think I'm halfway through now. Da-na-na. Oh, I also kind of want to show my new monitor setup. Monitors used to be set up like interestingly. Oh my gosh. Why is it making that popping sound? I don't like that. How do I fix it? It's making like a weird popping sound. It's like popping a... I probably have to do with this. I have to like add it to each other. Combine it and just like deal with it like that. It's still doing it. Strange. Yeah, it's doing a little bit less now. Oh my. Figured it out. I got it. Whoa. This song is by You Know Me. I love You Know Me's music. It's like a future based, like kawaii based type of like music, and it just works so well, you know. It's really good type of music. Like, this is the type of music I want to learn how to, I want to do. I just don't have like the experience of like producing, so I just don't know what sounds good. But eventually, I will, and I want to make some kawaii bass, bro. I like this type of music. Yeah, me too. Nadia, I think we have a lot of common. We could like be friends or something. Just saying. Similar to Snail House. I like Snail House as well. One of Snail House's music is actually really popular right now, if I can look it up. What's the song I'm thinking about? Do you guys know the song I'm thinking of? There's like a really popular Snail House song that's like, that's kind of like, it's a meme at the moment. If I search a meme. Oh, it's Hot Milk. Hot Milk. This song is a meme right now. Have a good one, Steam Bub. Oh my gosh. Last night I was on Discord and I showed my friends a meme that I made. Let me see if I can recreate it for you guys. I'm trying to find a picture of a dog. The song though, it's so funny. Edgy anime. Yeah, that too, Shiny, not gonna lie. I have been watching some like animation meme videos from like artists from like a long time ago, and this song is also like a very like popular song for those animation memes, for like edgy furries basically. Like basically like every single part of the drop they'd be like, oh my gosh, I'm edgy, people don't love me, ah, my heart's broken, I'm gray and monochrome now, something like that. And then they'll be like fine like during the other parts of the song, but like, basically like, oh, I'm edgy not anymore, I'm edgy again. Not anymore. It's just like, wow, cool. All right, let me show you my meme that I'm gonna make live on stream right now. Check it out. I'm gonna play the song, but I'm gonna accompany it with some images. Are you guys ready to see my meme that I made? Hang on, check this out. All right, here's a picture of a dog. I did this last night with my friends and I was laughing so hard. I thought it was funny. And remember, this is like, I did this at like 4 a.m. and I was like, when it's 4 a.m., it's just like you lose comedy. All right, that's it. I'm done. That was basically what I was laughing at like the entire time yesterday. That was my meme. I made that. But I saw it on TikTok too. It was pretty cool. It was pretty good, not gonna lie. I wish I was good at TikTok so I can be famous and get children on my stream and then I'll ban immediately because they're kids. It's kind of funny because like Yuxi has a TikTok and like a lot of people who like find her on TikTok are kids, so we just banned them anyway because Yuxi doesn't allow people under the age of 18 to watch hers. Or at least like you can still watch, but you can't interact with chat, so that I thought it was funny. But like that's like the thing that she does. Where am I? I'm banned. Boom. I want to try getting in a TikTok, but there are so many kids there. That's true. Mm-hmm. One time, sometimes like, there's a person I know that's like one of my old friends. She has a TikTok, and every now and then, like she does TikTok like in the morning. She like is a morning streamer, so like I never watch her streams because it's not in my time frame to watch. Newtone, sick, yeah. Levity, I like using Newtone, yeah. They upgraded it too. Anyone else find it weird that there are kids help phone ads on a site that kids aren't supposed to be on? Interesting. Never realized. How you doing, Elevity? Do you make music too, or do you edit? Are you an audio engineer, bro? Bro, audio engineers unite. I'm just doing some mixing right now. Let's see here. But yeah, that's basically what all it is. Oh yeah, I was talking about one of my old friends. She does this thing where like, she'll go live on TikTok, and she'll just have her phone like pointing at her OBS, so you can see like a preview of like what she's streaming. But you'll actually have to go to her Twitch page like to actually see like her streaming. But like you can see that she is like live, and I feel like that's really interesting. It's kind of like a behind the scenes type of feel, and I don't know, it's interesting. It's really weird too because it's like a vertical stream too. It's like a vertical video. It's like. It's probably like it's like behind the video. The screen that the OBS is on is blurry too, so it's like not even focusing on it. It's kind of like you see it in the background. It's like, yeah, meta streaming. It's so interesting. Like I've never would have thought of doing that. I don't want to do that. It's weird because like you're still, there's people on TikTok still commenting like on that live stream, but you're definitely like not interacting on that stream. So I'm like, I don't know, man. You make music as well? Yeah, music's pretty cool. Not gonna lie. Ron's Rouge? More like cutie. What? You mean it? That's crazy, dude. You're gonna make me blush over here, dude. Oh my gosh. You know what happens when I get blushy? I just can't hold it in. You know, I get so nervous. Oh my gosh. Why would you make me do that? It's crazy. Bro. So cutie rogue underscore, bro. Your stream setup is clean. Thanks, bro. Yeah, I mean, I work a little bit. You know, I'm not just like a music guy. I'm also like kind of like a little bit of a graphic designer. I wouldn't consider myself at all a graphic designer, but I like to think that the assets I make for my stream are pretty streamlined, I would say. Like, check this out. Hang on, let me show you this. If I go to my gaming scene, right? Check it out. Oh, I made that too. Right, this is my gaming scene. Pretend there's a game on there, right? And then like watch what happens when I go full screen. I also use a voice command. So if I want to do like full screen gaming, I'll be like full screen game. Boom, and now I'm on my full screen game. Check it out with the horizontal chat box and check this out. This is one of my favorite features. Boom, look at that. It's stream labels that I can hide away on a click of a button. Look at that. Isn't that pretty cool? Cause you don't need to look at this. Like, you don't need to see who followed recently. You don't need to see who subscribed recently, bits, donations. I can just hide that away. And then whenever someone does follow and I want to like review it, boom, there it is. And I just put it away. Boom, it's gone. All right. So I have this scene. This scene's pretty cool. I just love the seamless transition. I also have a voice command going back. Game time. And boom, we're back on this scene. Full screen game. Boom, look at that. Isn't that cool? It's like one of my favorite things. Another one is when I do art streams. So I have a specific scene for when I do art streams because like I want to focus more on the canvas of the art and not like everything else. Cause like obviously like if I just do this one over here, then it'll just capture my entire screen. And like that's not the whole canvas because the canvas is technically like a section of the screen. So as a result, I made this scene. Boom, my art stream. You can see that the game side of the screen is more like focused on the it's not like rectangular. It's not exactly 16:9. It's more like, let's say 4:3 or what have you. And it just goes right into where the canvas is. I also have my art gallery, which you can see the past arts that I've drawn. So it's really handy to have an art scene where you can see the other things I've drawn. Scenes are cool and well thought out. Thank you, Elavidi. I've been streaming for 1 year and I've done all this. Not gonna lie, when I first streamed, like if you were here like a year ago when I first started streaming, I was like bleh, you know, but you know, time comes with wisdom. How long did it all take to set this all up? Probably like, I'm not gonna lie, like thinking of everything and putting it all out, it probably took like a couple of days. And probably if I had to measure like terms of hours that across the entire like couple of days, probably my entire day, to be honest. I procrastinate, to be honest. S tier for only 1 year. Yeah, I just do stuff. I'm really like lowbrow casual. Like, I don't even have a schedule like Elevity. Like, I'm not like, guys, thanks for coming to my stream. I'm gonna stream tomorrow at the same time at 3 p.m., guys. I'll see you next time, guys. And don't forget, on Friday, I'm gonna have a collaboration with the cool Keys_and_I_whatever. And I don't have any of that. I don't organize. I literally am just as casual as any other streamer. I just make stuff and it just comes out eventually, right? I stream whenever I want. I'm really lowbrow, to be honest. I'm just very casual. That scene was really messy, by the way. That was not supposed to look like that. I still have to fix that. By the way, if you guys are wondering what the sound effects are, I'm watching a video called 1 hour of complete silence, but every now and then like a Vian boom sound effects comes out. So like, yeah, that kind of keeps me on my toes, to be honest. Yeah. I'm just vibing, dude. Like, I'm doing commissions right now. This is a commission. I'm just like helping one of my friends mix a song, you know? Yeah, so don't think like I'm like a freaking famous VTuber. I'm literally just some random Asian kid. I'm a random kid on the internet just like you. I'm just like you. Yeah, so with that said, welcome to the stream. Hi, I'm Ron, and I'm a certified audio engineer. I like to play games, and I like to draw. Yeah, random Asian kid gang, woo! Nyadia, shut up, you are literally a partner. And I'm not. Yeah, shut up, partner. You're gonna make me act like VR chat when, like, people with purple names are literally, like, shamed because, like, they play so much VR chat. It's like, oh, you're a trusted user? Haha, trusted user. Imagine being a trusted user in VR chat. Haha. I don't know. Damn. Yeah, so it's exactly the same thing. I discriminate against partners. If you're a partner, I just hate you automatically. Sorry, I don't make the rules here. It's just how it is. I'm just kidding. I don't I'm not like that. That's dumb. Bangar, did you just come from the Yuxi stream? What's up, Majin? Or Mahin? If you read it that way, I don't know. What is this? Okay. Yeah, so yeah, this is a FL Studio stream. Sometimes I stream video games when I feel like it. Sometimes I stream myself drawing because I feel like drawing. Yeah, drawing is pretty cool. I've been drawing for about a year as well. My first stream was like a Animal Crossing stream, and I drew like my first picture ever. It was like on February 11th or something when on 2020. It's the first way. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Imagine. Yeah. What's up, Imagine? What up? You're Imagine, as in as opposed to someone else's Jin. You're Imagine. I own you, or you're. I think you're mine. You know. Yeah. Here, let me show you. Let me show you some of my art that I drew a long time ago. Check this out. Let me show you the first thing I ever drew on stream. Playlist. This is the first thing I ever drew. This is Kaguya Luna, and this is my friend Zolgabur. She's one of my good friends. I drew this because she gave me my first subscription on Twitch when I became affiliate. And so as a thank you, I drew a little picture for her. And so yeah, I drew that. Nice. And then later on, stuff comes out and I just draw some more stuff. And I just draw some random stuff. I don't even know what's on here anymore. Imagine, thanks for the follow. Thanks. I don't even know what else I drew. But now I draw stuff on, I also have MS Paint doodles. I draw MS Paint sometimes. I draw on Clip Studio now. Let me see if I can show some Clip Studio drawings. I drew this drawing. This is on Clip Studio, which is a software I paid for but never used for a long time. This is one of my friend's OCs. I thought it'd be really funny to draw him as like a really long like cat-looking character. I thought it was funny and cute, so I drew that. And then I also drew this. This is for another one of my friends. This is for Emo Shimo, and another VTuber streamer that I'm friends with. This is her bat character. She's a bat girl, and this is her little like stuffed animal Benji. So I drew this for her because she commissioned it. It's one of my more prouder works. I worked hard on it. Can you run the song from the top? Yeah, I can definitely show what I have worked on so far for the song. Let's check it out, shall we? It's not done yet. So if you guys don't, know what this project is a song cover that was commissioned by one of my other good friends. Nadia's in chat. Say hi, Nadia, but in an Australian accent. You have to say an Australian accent. So she sang a song and she wants me to help her put her voice in the song and make it sound really good. So this is what I got so far. It's definitely not done. This is definitely like a rough draft. Oh, there she is. It's Nadia. Round of applause for Nadia. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to play what I have so far. All the green tracks, which is mixed. All right, let's go. 3, 2, 1. I'm still waiting for that one more harm. Cause this one's incorrect.
して君との虹の始まりを追いかけるって大繋ぐ雨上がりの空には吸い込まれるような青さが広がって痛すぎた揺れて気がしたんだそれは
consider it a pre-chorus instead of a bridge. But I feel you. And then I got this here, and then the rest of it's unmixed. So I'm not gonna play the untuned parts. That's basically it. Oh, by the way, Nyadia, you recorded something that like I wanted to ask for, but I found out that you actually sang it, but like for a different part of the song. So technically, if I play the raw parts right here, let me just enable these tracks again. Check us out right here. Like this right here? This is from a this is from this. You sing this.
Chica.
This is from the last chorus, and I was like, you know, I need this for the actual thing here, because like if you look at here, I make harmony guides for my clients. So Nyan is my client, and if they struggle with like harmonies, I don't mind making like a harmony guide for them. So I made this. I found that this is a thing that I need to hear. Let me enable the things. All right. So my harmony guides sound like that. Let me just play it. So as you can see, if I mute this and only access this part, I needed this. I needed this. Like, I needed that part. And I was like, Nadia, I'm gonna have to ask for another, line from your girl. And I found out that you actually sang it at the last part. So technically, I'm just going to copy and paste this little section right here and just paste it to every single part that requires it. So I'm just going to like that and boom, I got it already. So I'm just going to do that because it requires it. You know how it is. I find a missing puzzle piece and I fill in the gaps. And that's what I do. That's what I do. It's what it is. It is. Oh, what it is. Okay. Let's see here. Let's keep working, shall we? What was I doing again? Oh, I was doing this. Mixer. I think this is done, though. This is a harmony, by the way. And that sounds good, so I think I'm just gonna plop that into the playlist, and then we'll get into mixing it a little bit, and then we'll move on to the next thing I need to time and tune. Let me just turn on my snap grid real quick and just move it just a little bit down. Alright, playlist. Alright, so over here now, this is the thing I just imported in here from Newtone. Let me just get rid of this right here because this is what she's saying. I'm actually gonna get rid of this. These are old harmonies and just put it in here. There we go. So like this, I'm just gonna line it up to where she sang it. Let me mute my background music real quick. And let's see how it sounds together after I put this into the correct spot. So let me normalize real quick. Add it to its correct thing in the mixer. Where's the mixer? Here, I'm gonna see which one it goes in. This one goes in harm one, I assume, because this is a harmony. Yeah, let's put it in there. And boom, it should be just good to go, I think. Playlist? By the way, those are also voice commands. If I say mixer or playlist, it switches between the screens. Voice commands are super handy, by the way, dude. Like, if you don't want to press buttons and just, like, say what you want to do, it's so handy. I even have, like, voice commands for, like, sound effects. I like your instant colors on my mixers. Mine's always crazy colors. Yeah, I just keep mine organized. So check us out. If I want to make fun of someone, if their shoes are dirty, I'll be like, that's why your shoe's raggedy. And it'll play like the boom sound effect. I think it's funny. All right, let's listen. All right, so I got that part. There's another harmony in here. What she's saying is a lower harmony. So if I just, you know, cut this part up and just preview what it sounds like. As you can see, that is a lower harmony. This song is crazy because there's like three stacks of vocals. There's the main, the high harm, and then the low harm, which is pretty crazy for most songs. Most songs usually just has like one harmony max usually. But, you know, they're basically singing an entire chord. Like, look at this harmony guide. Like, these ghost notes here, this is like an entire chord. You need like at least three notes to be like an entire chord, basically. Isn't that crazy? So I thought the song was pretty wild to even have that. And how I make these, by the way, if you guys are wondering, I just listen to by ear. I literally just listen to the song by ear and just pick them out, you know? I have a selective hearing for these type of things. And I also have this. This is called an invert. What's really cool sometimes is that whenever producers provide like instrumentals for their music, you can technically use the instrumental to cancel out the music. If you line it up like to the dot, if you line it up and just invert the instrumental, you can technically, because of the waves, the way like sound waves work, you can just cancel out the song and just leave only the vocals. So I tried that to the best of my ability. I just put it on in Audacity, and this is what it sounds like. Just like listen to this. And this is what the original sounds like. Let me check my mixer real quick. Yeah, here it is. This is the original. And this is the invert. Just listen to that. Just listen to how, like, it gets rid of the music almost, like, almost entirely. Isn't that crazy? So because I have this file that I basically made by myself, I can hear like a lot of effects that I can use in my mix. You know, like even like this part right here. Like listen. I can hear like all the harmonies very well. Just it's basically how I did this, like this part, like I can hear all the harmonies, so that really helped out. Yeah, EQ helps, obviously. EQ does help. I do use that every now and then, but I don't really need to. I just like to do it by ear. It's just quicker. I don't need to look at an EQ. I just like I hear it, boom, it's on the keyboard. Boom. Also, hello cheap feelings. How are you? Do I even need to ask? Your feelings are cheap, as per says your name. Ooh, where's the random boom Vine boom sound effect when I need it? I'm listening to a video called 1 hour of silence occasionally broken up by Vine boom sound effect. So that would have been perfect if it came out. But yeah, you know, it'll just play whenever it wants to, I guess. I mean, it's whatever. It's not like I want it or anything. And by the way, Nyaria, you recorded these has, but like only during like the part where like it was very obvious for you to hear it, like right here. Like you heard it right there. Oh no, I'm in the red now. Uh-oh. Guys, my stream is going red. Imposter, what's his name? 8,464,851. Thank you for the follow. Really appreciate it. And I'm glad you're doing well. By the way, guys, sometimes my internet poops out. So, yeah, check it out. My OBS says that I'm in the red right now. So, that's not good news. I honestly, because of that reason, I might end soon, you know? I hate being in the red. Dude, it's freaking sucks, dude. Look, hang on. Let me show you a screenshot. Check it out. I'm in the red right now. I'm gonna cry. Oh my gosh. Sad face. I was about to say I don't remember doing ha there. Nyaria, I'm just glad that like you even recorded it at a part that like you heard it, because like I'm just gonna like just copy and paste it to where I need it anyway. So it's all good. It's all good in the hood. So it's pretty good. Yep. Yeah, red, that means, yeah, I know, Sag. But I'm going to persist, and hopefully it clears up. I'm just going to keep going and just see what happens. I wish your internet is better. Yeah, me too, Nyaria, don't we all? Like, let me mute this instrumental, this, okay. All right, let's put on some background music, and I'm just going to go continue mixing until hopefully it clears up. If it doesn't, heist Yastro. If it doesn't, I might just end stream soon. So if this is the last thing I say, then goodbye. But for now, I'm going to keep mixing. Let's go. Let's go. Mixer. Okay. Let's see where the next harmony is. I need to do this thing here, right here. Where is it? Right there. Just bring that over here. Boom, check it out. Bum bum bum. This happens a lot though, like me dropping frames. I don't know what it is. Like I know I live with the family, but it's all because like it's like upload speed, right? It's freaking me over. I don't understand. I'm dropping so many frames right now. I'm in the 3K. You thought America had top-notch internet? No, I think, isn't it Korea? Korea has like bomb internet. It's like super good, right? I thought it was Korea. I might be wrong though. Who knows? Yeah, but yeah, welcome to the stream. If you guys can manage to even hear what I'm saying right now, it's probably like super laggy right now. If it's like super buffering, I'm so sorry, guys. Maybe I just need to talk to my ISP, you know? Just gotta call them up. Hey, yo, Comcast, or I don't even know what I use. It's probably Comcast, not gonna lie. Just gotta call them up, be like, yo, what up with my upload speed, bro? I'm gonna give them a test of their medicine. It's always at night too. I don't get it. Like, how does the stream look on your end? Threaten the ISP? I might go to jail for that. Anyways, I'm gonna look up. I'm gonna watch my own stream and just see how it looks. All right, check this out. Let's see how my own stream looks. Let's see here. It's always at night too. Oh my gosh, it's so back. Oh my, ew. I don't get it. Oh, that's terrible. Look how delayed that is. Hang on, let's see. Can I advanced video stats? No way. Oh my gosh. It's around the same time everyone peak traffic time. I don't even know, man. Like, how does the stream look on your end? Threaten the ISP?
It's so bad.
All right, I think because of this, guys, I think I might just end early cuz I can't stream like this, bro.
Check us out. Let's see how my own stream looks.
Oh, latency says 1 second too, but meshes appear like 30 seconds, man. Yeah. I think I will end because of this. So sad. Sorry. Very delay. All right. Let's raid someone. This scene is not suitable for raiding someone in. I gotta go back to my other screen. Alright, guys. It was fun while it lasted. But hopefully it will be better on a different day. You know, sometimes I'll have days where it's literally perfect. The internet will not F up at all, but you know, sometimes it's just one of those days and I can't do anything about it, so it is what it is. Okay, so we're gonna raid someone. Let's see here. Looks like Yuxi's doing a charity stream. Do you guys want to save the trees or not? Yes or no? Or do you guys want to hang out with one of my my honeys? Want to hang out with my honey or Yuxi? Okay, I'm gonna give you a choice. Honey or rat? Honey or rat? You guys want to raid honey or rat? Raid my honey or raid the rat? It's either the honey or the hat. The rat, I mean. You wanna raid the rats? Wanna save the trees, guys? Sean says honey. Rat's just memeing right now. Bruh, she's just memeing right now. Alright. I'm gonna raid my honey then. Alright, gonna raid my honey. All right, raid. I'm gonna raid my honey. That's the raid message, guys. Hi, honey. Hi, honey. I'll see you guys later. I'm like typing this out while I'm saying it. I'll see you guys later. Here's my links if you guys want to check out my stuff when I'm offline. Stuff like that. And bye. I need to get out of here, bro. I need to fix my other scenes too. But yeah, thank you for stopping by. I need to work on this later. I'll see you later.
ASMR. Could be
this is my honey, by the way. If you guys can still hear me, it's my honey. He's really cute, and he's just enjoying some dwarf fortress. I don't even know what this is.